Child, and drop my thing. Anyway, good afternoon, it's Cynthia 212. I'm coming in here really quick to do a chat and eat. So really quickly, just to run my mouth. Not even sure if I'm gonna eat all of this, but as usual, y'all know my old standby, which is the vegan tacos. So we have some veggie beef or veggie ground, whatever you wanna call it. It's made from soy, and you just cook it like you would do ground meat, but you just won't cook it as long. I seasoned it with some taco seasoning and some salsa. I cut up some green peppers and some onions in it. And then we have some salad here. This is my favorite packaged salad. So this is the pomegranate one with pomegranates and sunflower seeds, and then it comes with its own dressing. So I just made the salad, and I had added some tomatoes and cucumbers to that salad, and I just mixed everything together with the dressing that came with it and just put it on a flour tortilla. So this is lunch and dinner. It's a little bit after 12 in the afternoon. So I like to cook dinner early, so y'all know me, get it out of the way. So Junior had half a day today, so I was making him something to eat, but then he fell asleep on the couch, so I'm not gonna talk too loud because I don't wanna wake him up. So it's just him and I in here. Now my youngest baby girl, Allie, she went out to go hang out with her friends. This is just some tea mix that you make. I like the McDonald's cups that they have, so I just kept the cup because I got ice out of here one day. So I just made some, I think this is some sort of a Lipton tea or something like that. You know, you put the powder in the water and you make it. So I made a big picture of it. Okay, so coming here to run my mouth. How are you all doing today? I season it very, very well. Because I use a taco mix that comes in a packet. And I also have regular taco seasoning. I think I use some Mrs. Dash Caribbean blend. And some teriyaki sauce. And when it was almost cooked, I just squeezed some lemon and some lime on it, which is really, really good. So let's talk about yesterday. My youngest baby girl graduated from high school yesterday. I'm trying not to wake up Junior. I woke him up. She graduated from high school yesterday, which was amazing. I told you I was gonna act a pluck damn fool, which I did, screaming, "Go Allie, go Allie, go Allie." So it was amazing yesterday. They didn't get that many tickets for high school. She only got 3 tickets. First, they only gave her 2. Then she was able to finagle an extra ticket. So it was myself and her father and her grandmother from her father's side. Yeah, I know I talk about her all the time, how amazing she is. So she was able to come. She was visiting from North Carolina. When she comes up, she'll stop up, you know, as many family members' houses as she can to visit, because she's no longer living in New York. So the time that she was up here, it coincided with Allie's graduation. So, and I think Allie is the last grandchild to actually graduate high school. I think Ma has 21 grandkids. I think 27 great grandkids. And great, 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 great grandkids. I think she only has like a handful. But my Allie's grandmother has a large, large family. So it was nice for her to see her, the youngest grandchild that had to graduate high school, So the graduation was at my college. So it was really nice. Excuse me. I apologize. Let me put this on Do Not Disturb. The ComHat lady is supposed to come for Junior, and Junior had a half a day today. So normally, when he has a half a day, she'll come and get him early, because her kids normally have a half a day. But maybe she got tied up with something. Anyway, so it was at my college. It started, well, she had to be there at 11, 11:30, and we had to be there at 1. So it went from like 1 o'clock to like 3. It was long, y'all. It was nice to see a lot of African-American kids get several awards. It was nice to see young men get awards. It was just, it was such a positive experience. It was a lot of fun. So anyway, like I was saying, Allie's grandmother came. I was so excited to see her. I haven't seen her in years. So it was really nice to see her. And after the graduation, they went out, and I came home because I had to be home for Junior. So I had to get home in time enough for Junior to get out of school. Even though Vaughn was here, I don't like to leave them two in the house for too much long because Junior is a bully. Devon just let him get away with doing whatever the heck he wants. I'm like, you're the older brother. How do you allow this little 10-year-old to bully you? But he's like, oh, that's my little brother. I'm like, so I didn't want to be out too long because Junior had school. So he was, Junior was in school from like 7:15 to 3. So he wasn't watching him for that long. I'm feeling full. Allie's father. Actually, her father and her stepmother got her a car. Excuse me. Let me talk my mouth full. I apologize. Got her a car for her graduation. Really nice. It's a nice starter car, you know. You're not going to buy, you know, your child her first car, a really fancy, dancy car. Because 9 times out of 10, they're going to do something to wreck that shit, right? So, they bought her a really nice starter car. So she was so excited. She said that, I think they went out to eat. And then, because she wanted to go to Red Lobster. Don't mind that. They are shooting firecrackers this early. It's not even July 4th, and they've been shooting firecrackers for the past 2 weeks now. It sounds like gunshots, but it's not. It's firecrackers or them big M80 shits that they be popping. So anyway, so Allie said that they were coming down the block, like her father was driving down the block, and then she was like, well, whose car is that in the driveway? And her father was like, I don't know. She was like, he was like, maybe somebody's at the house. So she was like, well, who would drive a car like that? Only like a creepy person or like a stalker would drive a car like that. So they were like, what? So they played it off, and she said they got in the house, and she was like, well, somebody's gonna leave their car in the driveway and then go into our house? That makes no sense. So she said when they got in the house, he handed her the keys, and he was like, well, welcome to Creepyville. Since she said whoever drives that car is like a creepy person or a stalker or something, he was like, well, welcome to Creepyville. So she was so excited. So she had texted me a picture of the car. So I was like, oh, I'm so happy for you. So that's always a nice graduation present, right? So she really had a really good time for her graduation. Like I said, y'all, I'm always give credit to what creditors do. Her grandmother and her father made sure that she had a really, really nice graduation, a nice prom, you know, all of that. So give credit to what creditors do. So she was happy about that. Now, I don't know if that means that she's going to decide not to go to my college, because I was like, well, is your father going to let you drive the car in New York? Because he lives in Jersey. And she was like, well, daddy said he has to register the car and stuff out there. But I'm like, well, your address is here. You live here. But whatever, y'all. I don't know. Maybe that was to ensure that, you know, she goes and lives in Jersey and go to school in Jersey and goes with him. I don't know if that was like the nail that sealed it, you know, the coffin. I don't know. But it is what it is. She'll be 18. She's free to decide what she wants to do. Like I said, I was hoping that she would be going to my college. But at the end of the day, like I said, the decision is hers. And I'm not going to be banging my head against the wall about it. So if she goes to live with her father, then that's what she does. So my job was to get her through her 4 years and across that stage, and I was able to accomplish that. So when you're going to be 18, you make the decisions of your own, and wherever the chips may lay, they may lay. So I'm not going to worry about it. Yeah, so that's pretty much that was going on. Devon was kind of hurt because he was like, that's not fair. He was like, how's she get a car when she graduates high school and I didn't get anything? And I'm just telling him, it, you know, just be happy for your sister. It is what it is. It makes no sense to, you know, at some point it doesn't make any sense to get upset anymore about it. But he was really hurt. But he was like, only thing I asked daddy for when I graduated was an Xbox, and I'm still waiting for it. I'm like, it is what it is. So anyway, I'm happy for my baby. It's just weird. Like, I did a video yesterday for Allie. What was weird is to go back and look at old pictures and videos of her and stuff like that. Y'all, when I tell y'all to cherish every moment of your child's life, whether good or bad, whether difficult or not difficult or whatever, maybe cherish it, because in a blink of an eye, they'll be walking across the stage. I was watching Allie's video that I did of her her first year of junior high school, her first day, and I had did like a video showing her, like recording her and showing her how to get to school and get back. Junior high school, y'all. She couldn't have been no more than like what, 10 or 11, I think. And now she's 18. Well, she's gonna be 18 in December. It's just crazy, y'all. And I said to myself, I got three down, one more to go, okay? My oldest got her GED, and Devon and Allie graduate high school. And I just got one more, y'all, junior. Just one more, and then I'm done. Well, as a parent, you're never done, but what I'm saying as far as getting them across that stage. So, this taco is pretty good. I like the way I season the meat very well. Well, meat. It tastes really good. And the flour tortilla, it's really good. It holds up very well. I took too much of a big bite. The crunchiness from the cucumber and the seeds is really nice. So the next step for Allie is, she took the placement test at my college, and she didn't have to take the English part because she did very well on her Regents test in high school. And she took the math, and she didn't pass by like a couple of points. So they're offering a free 2-week class for her so she can take the test again so she doesn't have to take remedial classes. But I spoke to her today about it, and she was like, well, I don't know. So I have a feeling that she's not going to go to my college. So, but I'm like, whatever college you go to, you still have to take an entry exam. And you're going to have to pass it. It's just that like time is winding down because the semester starts in August. So at one point she said she was just thinking of getting a job for the summer. Then she was saying going down south with her grandmother, but the ink hasn't dried on the diploma yet. So she still has time to decide. I know she's like, it's like a whirlwind to her. She's like, Ma, I cannot believe that I am no longer in high school. Like, it's like really over. Like, she was like, I don't even want to say high school grad or college student or whatever. She was like, I'm still an alumni from my school. I'm like, no, honey, you're a graduate. You're a college student now. So, I don't know. My thing is I'm afraid for her to take time off because you know how like kids be like, oh, I want to take a year off. And a year goes to 2 years and 2 years goes to 3 years. And then before you know it, so much time has passed and things have happened to where you put college on hold. So that's my thing that I'm afraid of, is that she's going to put it on hold and, you know, regret it. But hey, it's their life and they're more than willing to, you know, make as many mistakes as possible to learn a lesson. So I'm just happy for her. I really am. Because 4 years trying to get her ass across that stage, y'all. The numerous mommy talks I had to have with her. So I'm just excited. I'm just proud of all of my children. Okay, now this wants to kind of fall apart. But anyway, that's it. I spoke to the lady from my college at the disability department. So she said that my classes will be paid for. So I'm just so excited, y'all, to get into school. I was telling my daughter, like, the next time going to my college, you will be seeing me walk across the stage. Or, you know, we're both going to be walking across the stage together. Like, it's just amazing. I'm so ready for this journey, y'all. I'm, like, so freaking ready. I played no games, y'all. Whatever I had to do, I did. I played no games, okay? I did what I had to do very quickly. I did do the process very quickly. This is the end. I'm kind of full. So I know we ain't supposed to be licking our hands. I know that, but this is a chat meet. What I do every goddamn time I eat. If I want to, I'm gonna do it. It's not like I'm sharing my food with anybody, so. Yeah, that's it. I just came here to ramble. I don't really have much to talk about. I do. But sometimes there's a time and a place to talk about stuff. Sometimes you just need to meditate on some stuff. And sometimes you need to talk about it or deal with it. Sometimes you just need to let it go. And, yeah. You ever heard of that saying, learn to pick your battles? That's it, y'all. So thank you to everybody who watched the graduation video that I dedicated to Allie and her grandmother yesterday. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Like, some of my family members seen it and my friends, and it was like, girl, you got us over here crying, girl. Because they could just remember Allie being little and, you know, like I said, y'all, time goes by fast. Truly treasure every moment with your children because, like I said, in the blink of an eye, they'll be graduating elementary, junior high, high school, off to college. In another blink of an eye, they be getting married, having kids. So in another blink of an eye, I'll be old. What a head full of gray hair. Probably arguing with somebody in a nursing home. You know, my old self with the wheelchair. So, I'm going to go and thank you so much for listening to me ramble on. I love you all. Thank you so much for your love and support. And remember to say good morning, good evening, good night to someone with a smile. It'll definitely brighten their day, evening, or night. And God bless you all.